Well, Jim, a good entertaining game today. Plenty of goals for the fans and the right result from your point of view.
Yeah, I thought we started the game well. Apart from maybe in possession, I thought we were a wee bit sloppy. The passes were just going a wee bit astray. But once we got it sorted out, first goal obviously settled us down. And I thought we played terrific today. And we played at a great tempo, worked hard. As soon as we lost the ball, you could see them hunting, trying to get it back, played some good football. And, you know, it was always... It's always a difficult game, and but at the end of the day, what's the difference now is that in the last three games we've started to not just make the chances, make a lot of chances, but we'll start to put the ball in the net, and that's two home games now where we've scored four goals in each game, two extraordinary. Just shows you Morton down there today, top of the league, and found it difficult. So the team's maybe hopefully just gained a bit of momentum, turned the corner a little bit from that wee sticky month we had. So I thought they were playing well at that time, just wasn't happening for them. Maybe that's the difference now. It's just started to turn and gain a wee bit of confidence, momentum, and we're onwards and upwards, and hopefully we can just keep it going.
You need to shuffle the formation a wee bit with Lewis Martin pulling out the one or two players in unfamiliar positions, but didn't seem to make a difference.
Well, that may be the reason we were a wee bit vulnerable for the goals, but you've got to say that there's not a lot we could have done, because you know Lewis is called off. He's been in great form. He's called off groin strain on Thursday after training. Didn't respond on the Friday, too sore. And of course, the natural replacement, Big Stuart Urquhart, he's got the same problem. So you know, we know Roscoe's played mostly 20s back there for us, not played in the first team, but I felt Andy Gagan's had enough experience at right back, so you know, it meant Tomo, and I would probably have, you know, had Tomo up front and left Gozy, who's not trained a lot, to maybe come on for the bench and prove a wee bit of fitness for Tuesday night, but we had to bring him forward. I felt most of the team was, there were a couple of changes for the last home game here, which we tried to keep to a minimum because it was the same midfield, same front three. And again, they showed they've come up with four goals. What pleased me was that the two goals that we got were bits of a setback, but we just picked ourselves up. Shawnee scored a fantastic goal, and it was a great response to losing, because that's a goal at that time, had enough time for Ayr United to maybe get a lift, cause us problems, but it must have been a big blow to them when we scored so quickly. And it was a great move, plenty of people in the box, and it fell right for us, and this time we stuck it away, whereas maybe a few weeks ago we weren't. So. We're definitely improving, and we've definitely got a wee bit between our teeth now. And that wee edge to competition for places has made it good as well. And I think you know, we miss Michael Muffet today as well, because his wife in labour, and so we had to make a couple of adjustments at the back. But hopefully we'll see over the next 40 hours if we can get these injuries cleared up, and we'll see what we can do on Tuesday.
Yeah, one or two picked up knocks again today, but just need to assess.
Yeah, Gozy's not training a lot, and hopefully it might be a knock on the same party that caused him it, so I'll keep my fingers crossed I'll get through that. And Shawnee took a wee bit. I thought Shawnee Byrne was outstanding today. I mean, it was a fantastic goal, but his overall play today, controlling the ball and setting up, prompting and everything. So, but I thought every one of them, you know, didn't let the club down. And they're a good little side, and you know, people should remember they're a young side, and that they're growing, and they need the backing, because they're certainly putting in the effort. Sometimes they make mistakes, which we know can happen, but they're so keen to make up for it and do well. And you know, right now they're well worth the watching, because they're playing some good stuff and scoring goals and making chances and putting everything into it. So it's about keeping it going, that's the secret.
As you say, with Morton losing today, it's all tightened up at the top again.
Well, we went down to fourth, you know, with a wee bad run, and but we're still there, you know, at the top, and a result goes your way, you win the next standing, and then suddenly you go to third, and then you know you're going up to sixth. So this is there's a long way to go, and what the lead at the top is, and it's just one game can swing either way. So as long as we are going to be there, it's where we are in May that counts, and if we're in and about there, because I think we'll get better and stronger, and we've certainly got the squad to know that if we get injuries or suspensions or even resting one or two and keeping it fresh, we can do that. So and it shows you that Roscoe and Andy, you know, had to play out of position today and did a great job for the team.
Well done today. Thanks, Jim. Thank you.